Hi, I'm Kaylyn, and this is Bible Science with Kay. Today, I'm going to teach you how to make elephant toothpaste. First, I'm going to show you the supplies you will need. First, you'll need goggles, a pan, 2 tablespoons, yeast, hot water, a funnel, half a cup, another cup, empty water bottle, hydrogen peroxide, dish soap, and 1 or 2 food colorings. First, take the empty water bottle, take the cap off, put it in the middle of the pan, take the funnel, put it on the empty water bottle, take the hydrogen peroxide and pour it all the way up to the top, but don't let it overflow. Just in case, pour it over here. So just in case you don't do what I did. Come on, weirdo. It might be heavy.
No, all the way to the top.
Okay. Now done.
Yeah, just a little bit more. Okay.
And pour it in the funnel. Then take the funnel out. You're done with the funnel, I think. Yeah. Next, you'll take... If you have 2 food colorings, you take both of the lids off, or one, if you just pick 1 color. 5 drops each in there, and then carefully swirl it around. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. 1, 2, 3, 4. I'm doing blue and red, so it will make pink and purple. Purple, because purple is one of my favorite colors. Ooh, look at that purple. Just look at it. So dark and cool. Next, you'll take the dish soap, put a tablespoon of it in here and fill it to the top. Don't let it overflow. And then you'll pour it in. Carefully pour it in because you won't have a funnel. Then swirl it around. Okay, first you pour 3 tablespoons of hot water. 1, 2, 3 in there. Then 2 tablespoons of yeast.
One tablespoon of yeast.
Then you're gonna stir it with a spoon. And trust me, it will not taste good. smell good. I don't know why I said taste. Why would you eat yeast? Ew. It would not smell good when you mix it together. Smell it, Mom.
It's bad.
Told you. Grown-ups never lie. My parents never lie. So, I need to tell you this. When we try to do a good deed or help someone without God, this is it. It's just tiny. But this is like God. When we add God into it, this is what it's like. See? See? When you add God's love, it like overflows with all this amazing love. And it's really beautiful. It's really beautiful. Now I like to share a Bible verse with you.
I have it marked.
Here we go. Philippians 1:9 says, I pray that your love will be overflowed more and more, and that you will keep on growing in knowledge and understanding. Thank you for watching. Bible Science with Kaylyn. Please subscribe to my channel.